Bonjour, bonjour, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Cyril. I used to be a stem cell researcher for quite some time, and this is why I can tell you about the science behind skincare ingredients. So for today's video, it's going to be a more serious topic. Not that I usually say crap about skincare. This is not the point. But I mean, you will see why. So today, I wanted to talk about something very important, and it is basically how the beauty community in general, mainly actually beauty brands, but also a lot of influencers, so whether they are YouTubers or also people on Instagram, that they paint a fake reality to all of us. That really triggers a lot of problem among all of us, actually. And I just want to start with something very straightforward, actually, is that we simply have pores and imperfection, and we should all need, myself included, stopping at scrutinizing every little flaws, every little pores, every little blackheads, every little scars of everything that we have on our face, but also on our body. And the main problem that there is currently, especially in the beauty community, is that there are so many just pictures that are so retouch like crazy Photoshop. Even now the videos are Photoshop to the point that they no longer paint any sense of a reality. And just with the power of lighting like I have just around me, you can already make your skin texture smoother, smooth out the pores and etc. And myself included, I almost always wear makeup during my YouTube video. I don't do it on my Instagram or very rarely. So most of the time when you see me on my story, I am like raw in the sense that I don't really have makeup. Usually when I have makeup, it's a little bit of powder, for example, just to mattify the T-zone, but basically that's it. And I've also completely stopped to use any filter on my story. Maybe from one time to time I will, but I mean, the whole idea is that we really need to put this in our head. What you are seeing on Instagram, but also in most videos on YouTube, they are simply not the reality. And it's important because I have so many of you who ask me like a question like, oh, my skin is so dreadful, I have so many imperfections and etc. and etc. And from time to time I ask them, can you just send me a picture? So it could be a picture of their face, or simply a picture of the area that troubled them. And when I see it, I'm like, oh, but actually your skin looks very good. Why are you complaining? It's because of all those crazy filters and etc. We have like a distorted view of reality, which is very, very unhealthy. A healthy skin has pores, which is completely normal. And remember something, also the size of the pores is genetic. So some of us are going to have bigger pores than others. And that is something that is absolutely normal. And we should not worry about that at all. Also, something else, it is important to not compare yourself to someone else. You are in your own route, literally. So just compare to yourself, compare to what you used to be yesterday, or the day before, or year before, and etc., and see how you evolve and how you are also within your own skin. But don't compare yourself to someone else, simply because they will always have someone who, thanks probably to genetics, will have a better skin like you, and it's not relevant. It's really, really not relevant. What makes you unique is simply you, because there is not someone else like you. This is as simple as that. The other point that I really wanted to touch on this video is, again, the representation of beauty image that we have. That is simply so sick, and I'm very, very tired of always seeing the same skinny person, the same type of beauty, especially like also in the Western world, but also in the Asian world. They are really like a stereotype of a beauty, and if you do not fit with those beauty standards, you just feel like an alien. But this is not reality. This is really not reality. We all of us as a species, we all came in different shape, in different size. We have different facial features, and there are different skin colors, god damn it, really. And that is so important. And unfortunately, even in the skincare world, most people that are represented, they are always white like me. And I'm like, hello, I am just a tiny part of the humanity, and this is so wrong. It is also so wrong for the next generation. I do think that is very important, especially for children, to have this diversity of image and to know that, yeah, there are different kind of beauty, and to have like a pimple or a big pores is also completely fine. So in the beauty community, we need more people of colors. We need a broader spectrum of beauty standards. We also need more guys that are into skincare. We need more representation from the LGBT community, and etc. And we also need more flows in a way to be like infused in the beauty community. I do think that it is a very strong message that I have for you today, and this is really something that I really, really believe, like deep down in my core. And I really don't like to promote any brands that does not promote those type of philosophy, especially with the image. I think one of the biggest issues, especially in the cosmetic world, in a way, it's really with makeup. When I still see those brands, especially like in France, for example, and they still doesn't have shades for very fair people or for darker skin tone, this is just straightforward. No. Like the last time I was talking with my friend Satya, I'm going to link her Instagram account, and she told me that she cannot find her shade in Kiko, which is a brand of makeup. This is just, no, we should all stop buying products from brands like that that do not offer a variety of shades for other people. This is a big no-no. The big issue in the skincare world is mostly with sunscreen. Really, I cannot stand all those brands that at least does not mention, and they almost all do it, that they have a white cast. Really, this is not possible, and they don't even acknowledge when they have, for example, a tinted sunscreen. You cannot even know the shade. Most of the time, you need to swatch it on your hands, but guess what? There is never any samples to try, like a tester or something like that, to try it. And therefore, at the end, you need to buy a product, and I have a ton of it, like in my home, that are not my shade, but are not also going to be the shade of most of you, which is something that is simply wrong. Every single one of you, whatever your skin color is, you deserve a good sunscreen. And this is really something that I will always focus on, and I will always denounce the brand that does not tell you this. And I will tell you, like, for example, Avène, the French brand, all their sunscreen, they do have a white cast because they use Tinozop M, which is an excellent filter, but they do not mention it on the damn bottle. So therefore, if you, for example, have black skin, you cannot use those damn products, and Avène does not disclose it, which is wrong. So I'm going to leave you with this, with those reflection. Of course, if you did like this video, give it a thumbs up. I thank you so much for being here, to be always there and present and always commenting and etc. The next video will be more, I would say, focused on skincare. Don't forget also to subscribe, to ring the bell. I have two Instagram accounts, one in English and one in French. I thank you so much for your time, and I will see you next time. Au revoir.